Welcome to Dunamis Year in Review 2021. Tonight, I just want to thank you guys for tuning in. I pray that you enjoy this session. This year has been a tragic year for a lot of people. A lot of lives were lost. A lot of families are broken in this pandemic. We have been inside. We have tried to go outside. We're limited with restrictions. But as our General Overseer, Apostle Richard Jones says, focus on the light. And Jesus Christ is that light. That is the light that gives us hope. So as we look back on what the Lord has done throughout our embassies, I pray with thanksgiving that you guys enjoy our year in review 2021. In the month of January, we started with the theme Reset, in which we did a short film based on that theme.
Morning, I just watched Reset my phone, so everything good.
Finally, yes.
Yeah.
Fine, that's smart. Now sounds smart for the new words too.
There was also the installation of Evangelist Nigel Laltoo and Pastor Joel Paul at our Penal Embassy branch. Evangelist Alyssa Macmillan was also installed in this month at our Tunapuna branch. You see what God was doing? Wow. And last but not least, our very own General Overseer, Apostle Richard Jones, launched his book, The Breaking.
And I'm so excited to be able to stand here to speak to you about my first book release entitled The Breaking.
Amazing. If you guys haven't read that, you need to read that. That was a good book. I read it 4 times and I have written all my notes. The theme for the month of February was Anchored. And during this month, you actually saw 2 deaconesses installed at our Grande branch. And that is Deaconess Phyllis Bonaparte and Deaconess Donecia Mannette. In March's theme, it was called I Survived It, where our leaders actually did a photo shoot for this. So every time one was coming up to preach, you would see that in the photo shoot. And let me tell you, that was really amazing. You guys should go back and look at that. Recap it. We had some testimonies from various members.
He provided provision for me. Like I said earlier, I have a good place, like to see how good God is.
Our very own Deaconess Nicole, Mahadeo, was also installed at our penal branch. We also had a very special event that has never happened in our embassies, and that is Men Feel Too at our Tunapuna embassy. April's theme was the Living Dead. And in this theme, we had to pray for our Prime Minister's help, in which God surely responded. It was in this month that we celebrated our 7-year anniversary as a church.
We now go live on the scene with our reporter, Natalia Homer.
Right? They've been making loud noise. As you can see, the wall has actually just fell.
That we should walk around the walls for 6 days in silence. And on the 7th day, 7 times. But on the last time, we're supposed to shout. And as we shout, boom!
But we didn't have enough worship leaders because some of you may not know, but we rotated across the embassy. In Tunapuna, it had a rotation. In Penal, sometimes Penal will come to Tunapuna, Tunapuna go to Penal. But there was a certain apostle at that time. Apostle Richard, he would begin singing. He would have his tambourine and his spirit fingers. A little more oil in my lamp,
keep it burning. A little more oil in
just
my
like
lamp, my friend.
Sing it again.
A little more oil in my lamp, keep it burning.
And this actually happened after the ending of our 7-week Thanksgiving and consecration period. And I'm sure ministry was birthed in people and many testimonies occurred in this period.
Do not hinder any child that has been called by God. Do not hinder the child that you have within your care, because God has a purpose for their life. So let them come on to Jesus.
We also had the installation of Apostle Lathalia Homer at our Grandy branch.
Allow anyone in our embassy, anyone, covenant partner, apostolic leader, and so forth, to grow hungry. No way I'm not going to allow any of that to happen. And so it is our responsibility as a church to take care of the needs of those who belong to our house.
For the month of May, we had to readjust to cope with the pandemic because the country was on a full lockdown. And you know, in this month it was Mother's Day, and Evangelist Latoya Benjamin did a powerful sermon on the voice of the mothers.
And when we begin to understand that it is not do as I say, but not what I do, that saying is incorrect. It is error. And as I will always say, there is no power in error. If you only begin to understand that the development of your child is as a result of your behavioral pattern, and I can testify to that.
If you have not watched that, you should watch it. Because mothers out there, you really need to understand how it is children are affected. We also launched a video series called Taboo.
In this series, we aim to give answers to those burning questions that you haven't yet found the answers to.
You see, faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God.
Ancient writings that falsely claim authorship by a biblical character.
Jesus is described as a regular looking man who, when scourged before his crucifixion, became so disfigured he did not resemble a human anymore. Isaiah 52:14.
In June, we explored the topic Armageddon. And we also started our fitness program online.
Good day, Dunamis family and the world. We're back at it again,
turn
right?
Up and down, keeping the body active.
And it's just to make your smiths. So we're going to add this in
as much as you can, as fine as it can be, yeah?
Right, no, black bean is an acquired taste, but I'm telling you, once we do this part of it...
There is also the relaunching of Jars of Fire, which is our youth ministry via Zoom and Facebook. And there are many poems and vlogs to keep us encouraged in this month.
There were times when I fell, there were times when I was down, there were times when I was far from God, there were times when I totally messed up and was devastated and I would beat up on myself. But God came and He continued to remind me that you are a work in progress. You are not perfect. Nobody is perfect. But I'm working on you, daughter. I'm working on you. And I want to encourage you.
Everything is written in God's word. How we supposed to live, the things we supposed to do. Yeah? Yes. Minister Jamal, want to say something?
What I just wanted to add quickly as well is that acknowledging you have a problem is one thing, right? And it's important as well. But you must acknowledge that you have a problem.
It is a process to be healed. And the healing that is required, you don't have to do it by yourself. You don't have to try to fix yourself. You need to allow the Holy Spirit that is given from the moment you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, to transform you, to heal you, to fill you, to give you that joy.
We also ended this month with a prayer for our SEA students.
Sicknesses will not befall them, that fear and anxiety will not overtake them. Let your peace be upon these children, O God. Let your love surround them, and let your will be done in each and every life. In Jesus' mighty name, amen.
You cannot take the mark of the beast by accident. You are taking the mark of the beast by purpose. And so it's not going to be accidental marking, but it will be from the heart and the spirit that they will say, this political leader is God. is deserving for worship.
We now look at the month of July, where we had a theme, Exhibit G. We will testify of His power. Within this theme, we looked at the gift of salvation and God's power within that gift of salvation. And many of our ministers shared their personal experiences and encounters with God and His power.
When you are born, you're not born knowing how to love, but it's when your parents show you how to love, then you learn to love and learn to show love to others. And that's what God is telling us here.
No matter if a teacher don't like you, no matter if you think you're ugly, because nobody is ugly, no matter if you're looking a certain way, no matter if your own family don't like you, you are a child of God.
The month of August, we saw Exhibit J continuing. So nice, we had to do it twice. In this month, the Tiny Truth Ministry launched their vacation Bible school titled Lit, Living in Truth.
VBS is always lit.
Yes, so we're going to learn about how to confess the truth, how to believe the truth, and how to defend the truth. And there will be lots of activities, Auntie. So we're going to make puppets. We're going to have a cooking segment.
The month of August also saw the installation of the overseer for the newly established Point 14 Embassy, none other than Apostle Kelly Jufa.
Rasok o robosh ela robos ai, robo yanga raba yanda rabash eka robosh ata, korobos ai. Father, dear God, this morning, Lord God, we anoint your servant, Apostle Kelly Cooper, O God, Father. Hallelujah. This morning we congratulate Apostle Kelly on her appointment as overseer of our Point 14 Embassy.
The month of September, the theme was Mirages. Within this month, a short film was presented titled Armageddon, which was based on our theme from June.
My name is Ethel Marguerite Jameson. I supposed to be good. I know how you can leave me here.
Wait. What's the news? Wait, point of it.
Everyone, welcome to Channel 7 News. I am news reporter Sharon Cox. Here at the studio, we have breaking news. The world is in chaos. Persons are missing. Persons have mysteriously vanished. Family members are gone.
Churches also reopened within this month, and so we happily continued with our encouragement and evangelism.
And as Christians, we are part of this war. We have a role to play in this war. And it is important to note that we are equipped for this war. And one of the weapons that we have is the Word of God. The Bible teaches that the Word of God is a sword.
To close off this month, we make special mention of a deep and powerful monologue ministered by our very own Roel Strong.
I hear about this Jesus man. Some Jesus thing, and but how he go bring freedom and set people free and nothing else. But I gave him a try and see. It's a little thing. I'm gonna see what is he seeing, because you know what? I lost and nothing here again. Everything gone. So let me get this Jesus I seen and really see what's going on here, boy. Cause way in the water, way in the water, children, way in the water, Jesus is gonna trouble the water.
The month of October, the last kingdom. Hampers were distributed within the Point Fortin community by our Point Fortin embassy along with Apostle Richard Jones. Our penal embassy also resumed their street evangelism. And within that month, we saw Apostle Richard Jones start a new series entitled Undefeated.
God wants you to live a victorious life. And so we got to understand that we are called to be undefeated, that we are called to be radical, that we are called to be more than conquerors. But one of the biggest problems and the biggest issues that we have to deal with when we are translated into the kingdom of God is dealing with generational curses.
There was also a silent film ministered by the members of the Sandy Grandy Embassy entitled The Grace of God. October is an exciting month because we also saw the launch of our very own newsletter within the Faith Life social media platform. There was also a rebranding of the Rescue Ministry, which is now called Redo.
Reason why we are in Dingo Martin is because God have sent us here to establish a ministry, a Dunamis Embassy here, to reach out to the people within the community. And so it is in our assignment to ensure that we are able to make the type of impact that we need to make. Evangelist?
Yes, it is very important, especially in a time like this where it is that we are seeing darkness wants to overtake, but we know with the power of God that will never be able to take place. But we, the church, have to do something. Say, if we don't go, who will tell them?
Right.
So right now we understand the call and the mission is not about playing but about souls, and what it is important in this time and in this season, because our young men are dying, our young women are perishing, and we need to establish God's kingdom so that we can conquer, that we can be able to do what it is that God has called us to do, to impact the entire nation.
In the month of November, we focused on the theme of Holy Spirit. Within this month, we saw the installation of Deaconess Cassandra Jones at the Tunapuna Embassy. God's Elite 2021, Shields Up. God's Elite 2021 was relaunched, entitled Shields Up, and this was done via Zoom.
You are the Lord of Lords, and there is none like unto you, O Father. And lift your name on high tonight, O God.
Would you say shields up and anchor yourself in God?
Yeah.
Because if it is that you don't, even if it is you're impenetrable, because if you just fall back and I will come and you might get it, but you fall down. And it's for you to be anchored in God.
We also had 7 days of intercessory prayer. And we celebrated a special birthday of our very own Apostle Richard C. Jones at the Sandy Grandy Embassy.
Happy birthday!
A dance was done to honor the departure of the overseer of Tunapuna Embassy, who moved on to begin the Dingo Martin Embassy of Dunamis Embassy.
Are the workers within the territory that God has called of Point 40. And so I just wanted to stretch your hands forward as we pray for them.
Last but not least, within the month of November, our very own Natalie Dixon launched her very first book entitled Wailing Road, Journey to Christ.
An encounter I had the day before my birthday. I had to choose life or death the night of a Friday. 23rd November 2018 is the date. Christ stretched forth his hand and told me I was not too late.
In the month of December, the theme was, "Oh come, let us adore him." And we saw the reinstallation of Dio Jovi Merez at the Tunapuna Embassy. Within this month, many of our young persons were also challenged with the task of doing their very own sermons. And I'm sure that many of you were ministered to and encouraged to see our young people do such a great job.
I am Latanya Laltoo, and I am here to speak to you on the theme, "O come, let us adore him." To adore means to worship and love something or someone, in this case, Jesus.
A mother's love for her son. We know there's a love that is brotherly, such as a love for a friend. We know that there is a love that is romantic, such as a love for a spouse. But the word used here, agape, signifies a love that is greater than all of those. A divine love that only God could demonstrate.
And I just was like in so much pain and not focusing on the things of God. And I didn't surrender myself to him. But those things, what I didn't understand at that time, is that was a distraction for me to stay away from the word of God. And so I'm thankful that I saw that and I had the help to come out of it. And the guidance as well. And I'm also thankful that I was obedient now.
And very recently, we saw our very own prophetess Sarah Jack launch her first book entitled Shackles to Stockings.
And the power of the blood. And I'm so glad that my freedom wasn't based on what I've done, but it's goodness and mercy. And the power of the blood.
I know we are so excited as we are getting ready to cross over into a new year, the year 2022. And so God has prophetically given us a mandate and a focus to be able to impact our nation with the gospel of Jesus Christ. Our theme for this coming year is Passion 1000. We are focusing on discipling 1000 souls for Jesus Christ. I believe with all my heart and with all my might that a life without Christ is a meaningless life. But a life that has come in connection with Christ is a life that now can fulfill purpose, can fulfill destiny. And so it is our commission and our mandate to be able to go into all the world and preach the gospel in the highways, in the byways, to the lost, to the perishing, to those who are desiring to have hope. And so we are not a people that are hopeless. Even in a time of a pandemic like this, we have a hope. We have the one that we can trust on. We have someone that we can keep our faith in. And so that someone is Jesus Christ. And so I pray and I hope that you will join with us in this coming year. It will be a radical year of the supernatural. It will be a radical year of seeing God's saving power, seeing God healing power, seeing God deliverance power, seeing God restoring families, seeing God restoring those that have been lost and bringing them back into His kingdom. The kingdom of God is not in a pandemic. The kingdom of God is secure in Christ. And so we are marching forward to be able to win the loss at any cost. We are marching forward into the highways, in our cities, in our communities, preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ by fire and by power in Jesus Christ's name. So be with us, join with us, connect with us for throughout the entire year of 2022 as we focus on Passion 1000.